So for the buck boost converter, we know for boost, V out is or let's take only greater. And for buck less than. So which means we need for basically if we need a converter which can do both, like V out is greater than or less than VDD, or in fact it could be same also, okay, or V out is buck plus boost. So let's say I have this, I will call it S1, S2, what is this, buck or boost? So what is V out here? If I call it VO1, D times VDD. Let's say I have L2. I will call it S3. What is this right hand side? Let us say I am operating with the same PWM where duty cycle is D. What will be VO2? VDD over 1 minus D. Okay. VDD or VO1? Okay, and what is VO1? D times VDD. So effectively VO2 is nothing but D over 1 minus D VDD. Okay. So what is this capacitor doing, C1? Do we really need this? I mean, we need to simply transfer the charge from one side to other side, and inductor very well can do that. So why do we need to store at C1? It is not required, huh? If I remove this, it will do the same job. Ultimately, I am only interested in VO2. I am not interested in VO1 at all. Then I can remove that cap. And now two inductors are in series. I can combine them and make into single. Okay. So let me just do this. Keep it here. Make it C out, and this is V out, okay. So we have saved one inductor and one capacitor, and now you can apply the same volt second balance and you will see, you will get the same expression actually. So you can do that. So now for V out less than VDD, what should be the duty cycle? What should be the range of duty cycle? Less than 0.5, okay. And this is your buck mode. For V out equal to VDD, what is D? 0.5, okay. This is what? This is buck boost, and for what should be D? Greater than 0.5. This is boost, okay. So now if I make D equal to 0.5, by the way, what will be the current? So V out is D over 1 minus D VDD, but what about the current? What about IDD. So, in the buck D times, and if you have a load here, I load, what will the current? One minus D upon? How come? Why? If right, look at the left hand side figure, what is the current in L2? What is the current in L2? We talked about it yesterday, boost. What is the current in boost? So what is the current in L1? They are in series. Same current, So your current will be driven by boost only here. Okay. Because for buck, the load is input current of the boost, and inductor current of the boost, because for L1, your L2 basically is defining the current, correct, and so your IDD will be, so I mean think about what will be that 0.5, D equal to 0.5. Twice current, okay, inductor current basically. Wait, this is inductor current, not the, what is this, IL, okay. So how much is the inductor current? 1 over 1 minus D into I load. So D equal to 0.5, what is the relationship between V in, V out? V in equal to V out, but what about the current?
I equal to twice the
current is 2x. Okay. So what will happen to the losses?
Losses will increase because power is higher.
So now let's say instead of that you operate only in buck and make D equal to 1. You will get the same thing? You will get the same thing, huh? In the buck, if you make D equal to 1, you will get the same thing, V out equal to V in. And what about the current, inductor current? I load. So what about the losses there? How much difference in the loss, I square loss you are seeing?
4 times
difference, huh? So why don't we do that actually? Why, I mean, if I want V out equal to V in, why do I need this buck boost? Forget about the boost part now. Let's say I want my range is only V out is less than or equal to V in. Do I still need a buck boost or I can do with buck only? Saturation means, what do you mean by saturation? Okay, let's say I don't have even that. You are allowed to make D equal to 1. Can I regulate my output to VDD? You cannot, huh? That is the ideal condition. What about the IR loss? V out equal to D times V in minus V loss. Under the condition of load, V loss will be finite. So, your V out will always be less than V in. You cannot make V out equal to V in. That's the ideal condition without any loss. The moment you have a loss, you cannot make. So that's why you require buck boost. Even if you want to achieve V out equal to V in, you cannot do with the buck. Even if you are allowed to make duty cycle 100%. Okay. That is only true under no loss condition, which means your load current should be zero. Correct. So now let's say here I want to achieve. So let's say I want D equal to 0.9. What is your V out? What is your V out? 0.9 over 1 minus 0.9 into VDD. How much? How much is this? Huh? 9 times? Okay, and if D equal to 0.1? Or let's say D equal to 0.4. Take the other condition. How much is this? 0.4 over 0.6 VDD. How much is this? 0.67 VDD. But what about this now? And what will be load current IL? I mean, not the load, the inductor current. 1 over 1 minus 0.4. 1 over 0.6 is how much? 67% more than your load, but my output is much less than VDD. Do I still need to do this and incur a lot of losses? I can only operate in buck. So, which means controlling S1, S2, S3 and S4 with a single duty cycle doesn't make any sense here. We should independently control S1, S2 and S3, S4. This is, by the way, conventional buck. If you look at it in literature, the conventional buck boost will be like this.